So in this lecture, I am going to discuss about nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. Nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. So spectroscopy is the interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter. Spectroscopy is the interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter. So in this NMR spectroscopy also we require the electromagnetic radiation. And even though any spectroscopy, the electromagnetic radiations are very, very important. Okay. Now NMR spectroscopy is the absorption spectroscopy where the molecule absorbs the electromagnetic radiations. And due to the absorbance of the electromagnetic radiation, certain changes are takes place in that molecule. And we want to see what type of the changes are takes place there. Okay. So to understand the NMR spectroscopy, first of all, we should be understand nuclear spin. Okay. We should be understand the nuclear spin. Now the phenomenon of NMR was given by the scientists Bloch, Hansen and Packard. Later on, Purcell in 1952 explained the NMR spectroscopy. And these two groups got the Nobel Prize. Bloch and Purcell awarded jointly the Nobel Prize in physics. But actually, this technique is very useful in for the chemistry. Okay, for chemist, for biochemist, for the structural elucidation. So let us see what is a nuclear spin. We are familiar with electron spin. We know that electron is revolving around itself. So electron is having the spin. Similarly, the proton is also having the spin. As electron revolving around itself, either clockwise direction, anti-clockwise direction. Similarly, the proton. Proton means hydrogen atom. Okay. So proton is also having the nuclear spin. And it is also rotating around its axis, around its own axis. So the positively charged spinning proton generates a small magnetic moment. Okay, when the proton spins about its own axis, it will generate a small magnetic moment, making behave like a proton as a teeny magnet. Making behave as a proton like a teeny magnet. Now where the protons are present? Protons are present into the nucleus. Okay, the nucleus that contains the proton. It means that that nucleus also possesses the spin. Okay, you can see, I would like to show this. Okay. 1 minute. So, let us show this. We know that. Consider the example of the hydrogen nucleus. Hydrogen atom. Now hydrogen atom, it is having only one atomic number. So the nucleus of the hydrogen atom can be represented in this way. Okay. So there is only one proton and only one electron in the hydrogen nucleus. In case of hydrogen, there is only one proton and only one electron. Electron is revolving around the nucleus and protons are present here. So therefore, we can write here hydrogen, it is having one proton and one neutron. One proton and one electron, atomic mass number one. So hydrogen nucleus is having the nuclear spin. Okay, it is having the nuclear spin. As like of electron, electron is having the electron spin. Okay, electron spin. Electron is rotating around itself. Okay, it is rotating around the nucleus as well as rotating around itself also, own axis. Therefore, it is having the electron spin, and proton is also having the similar behavior. Okay, and protons are present into the nucleus. So nucleus is having the nuclear spin. Okay, nucleus is having the nuclear spin. So the spin of the nucleus is the vector sum of the spin of the protons and neutron present in the nucleus. The spin of the nucleus is the vector sum of the spins of the protons and neutrons present in the nucleus. Because in the nucleus, neutrons are also there. So the spin, the total spin of the nucleus, it is the vector sum of the spin of the protons and neutrons present in the nucleus. And that spinning nuclei generates a magnetic moment. Okay, when that proton gets spin, that neutron gets spin, and that spinning nuclei generates a magnetic moment. Okay. So depending upon the resultant spin of the nucleus, it may or may not behave as a magnet. Okay, what is the resultant spin? If the resultant spin becomes equal to zero, then it is not showing, it is not behave as a magnet. But if it is having some spin value, then it shows magnetic moment. So in order to obtain the nuclear magnetic resonance spectra, a nucleus must possess a spin. This is the very important criteria required for the NMR spectra. In order to obtain the nuclear magnetic resonance spectra, a nucleus must possess a spin. Just like you know, a bowler, that is a spinner, spin the ball, okay, spinning that ball, and due to that spinning that ball, the batman not playing that ball very well. Okay, so in order to obtain the nuclear magnetic resonance spectra, a nucleus must possess a spin. Such nuclei are called spin active nuclei. Nuclei with zero nuclear spin do not give NMR spectra. What is the condition? Nuclei with zero nuclear spin do not give NMR spectra. Okay. So nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy involves, what is NMR? NMR involves the change in the spin state of the nuclear magnetic moment when the nucleus absorbs electromagnetic radiation. What happens in the NMR? It involves the change in the spin state of the nuclear magnetic moment when the nucleus absorbs electromagnetic radiation. There must be the change in the spin state of the nuclear magnetic moment when the nucleus absorbs electromagnetic radiation in a strong magnetic field. It means that we have to apply the magnetic field is also there. Okay, we have to apply the magnetic field is there. So you can see this slide, NMR spectroscopy, NMR nuclear magnetic resonance. You can see here nuclei in presence of the magnetic field. There are certain changes are taking place in that nuclei. Without magnetic field, generally changes are not possible. Okay. Without magnetic field, generally changes are not possible. So magnetic field is essential here. Okay. Now, if we talk about the nuclear spin, you can see here the nuclear spin. This is the ethane molecule. Ethane molecule, it is a organic molecule. You can see in the diagram. So carbon bonding is there. but carbon atom does not shows any NMR because nuclear spin of the carbon I becomes equal to zero. Nuclear spin, it is denoted by the I, so it does not shows any NMR carbon. But proton, and we know that most of the organic molecules are having the hydrogen atoms bonded to the carbon atom. Okay, so the NMR spectra, it is due to the presence of the proton. Okay, so in this case, all these protons are equivalent type of the protons. 6 hydrogen atoms are there, they are equivalent. Okay, this is a methyl proton, this is also methyl proton. So now the nuclear spin of the proton means hydrogen atom, it is equal to 1/2. So the NMR spectra of this ethane molecule, it is due to the presence of the proton, and it can give the NMR signal. Nuclear spin I, it is equal to 1/2. Okay, nuclear spin I for proton, it is equal to 1/2. Then it can give the NMR spectra here. You can see here, criteria required for NMR signal. Nuclei should have spin quantum number I equal to 1/2. This is a very important criteria. We know that nuclei contain the proton and neutrons. So the nuclear spin of the proton, that is I, should be equal to 1/2. Then we can apply the external magnetic field to such proton. Then we should supply energy in the form of electromagnetic radiation, EMR. That resonates with the energy gap. So particularly radio waves are required here, radio waves. The electromagnetic radiation, which radiations are required? Radio waves. So these are the three important criteria for the NMR signal. Nuclei should have spin quantum number I equal to 1/2. We should apply the external magnetic field. And we should supply the energy in the form of the electromagnetic radiation. We know that electromagnetic radiations are the energetic radiations. So when nuclei, we absorb that radiation, what happens? Transitions will be take place from lower energy state to the higher energy state. So this is the essential criteria for NMR signal. So let us see in detail now, what is NMR? Well, it involves the change in the spin state of nuclear magnetic moment when the nucleus absorb electromagnetic radiation in a strong magnetic field. See, what are the conditions are required here? The nuclei should possess the nuclear spin, first thing. And it involves the change of the spin state of the nuclear magnetic moment. It involves the change of the spin state of the nuclear magnetic moment. When the nucleus absorbs the electromagnetic radiation in a strong magnetic field. In a strong magnetic field. Okay. So try to understand this. Now, if we irradiate the precessing nuclei, precessing means spinning nuclei, just like a ball, which can be spin. Okay. So if we irradiate the precessing nuclei with a beam of electromagnetic radiation, then the low energy nuclei will absorb it and move to the high energy level. Electromagnetic radiation provides energy. Okay. Electromagnetic radiations provides energy. And due to that, what happens? Nuclei will absorb it and move to the higher energy state. Just like when we supply the energy to the electron will be goes into the excited state. You aware about this? The precessing nuclei will absorb from the precessing means spinning nuclei. Absorb from the radio frequency source only. What type of the radiations are required? Radio frequency radiations. Very low energy radiations. Remember, in the electromagnetic radiations, radio frequency, it is very low energetic radiations. Okay. Only if the precessing frequency is same as the frequency of the radio frequency beam. That is when the quantum energy h nu of electromagnetic radiation matches up the energy difference between the two energy levels in presence of the magnetic field H0. And when this occurs, the nucleus and the radio frequency beam are said to be in resonance. With the help of the diagram, I am going to show this, how the resonance occurs there. When this occurs, the nucleus and the radio frequency beam are said to be in resonance. Therefore, that word is used here, resonance. Therefore, the term nuclear magnetic resonance is used. Okay. Nuclear magnetic resonance, it is used here. Now, there are certain rules are given to predict the nuclear spin. Because nuclear spin is very important. If the nuclear spin becomes equal to zero, that nuclei does not show any NMR. Okay? So there are certain empirical rules framed to predict nuclear spin. The first rule, if both the number of protons and number of neutrons in the nucleus is even, both the number of protons and number of neutrons in the nucleus is even. See, suppose that this is a nucleus. Okay. And this nucleus will contain proton and neutrons. We know that proton plus neutrons. And if both protons and neutrons are even number, the nuclear spin becomes equal to zero. For such a nuclei, for example, helium 2-4, proton it is 2, neutron it is 4 minus 2, 2. 2 protons, 2 neutrons. Nuclear spin it is equal to zero. It means that helium it is not NMR active. We cannot get the NMR spectra for the helium nucleus. Oxygen, H16, even atomic number, okay, even number of the protons and even number of the neutrons. Carbon, 612, same, even number of the protons and even number of the neutrons. So such a nuclei, such element does not show the NMR spectra. This is the first rule, because nuclear spin becomes equal to zero. Nuclear spin, that is, it is denoted by the letter I. I, it is equal to zero here for such a nuclei. Okay. Such element. Rule 2. Nuclei containing both odd number of protons and neutrons will possess integral spin. Integral spin means whole number 1, I equal to 1, integral spin. Like this. Nuclei containing both odd number of protons and odd number of neutrons. For example, this hydrogen 1-2. Number of proton it is 1. Number of neutron 2-1-1. 1 proton and 1 neutron. So odd number of proton, odd number of neutron. So it is having the integral spin. So such nuclei may be NMR active. Shows the NMR spectra. Similarly, lithium 3-6. Okay, 3 proton number, 3 neutron number, odd number of the protons and odd number of the neutrons. This is rule second. Third rule. If either the number of the protons or number of the neutrons in the nucleus is odd, out of 2, 1 should be odd. Either proton or either neutron. The nuclei will possess half integral spin. half integral spin. For example, proton 1 1, this proton 1 1, you can see here, this proton number is 1, odd number. Neutron it is 0, 1 minus 1 0, 0 it is a even number. Either the number of protons or number of neutrons should be odd number. Out of these two, one should be odd. Then it is having the half integral spin, means I equal to 1 by 2. Carbon 6 13, okay, carbon 6 13, neutron number is odd here, 13 minus 6 7, and proton number is even, so it is having the half integral spin. So these are the rules. You can see here in this table, number of protons and neutrons and spin number, spin number I, number of protons even, number of neutrons even, I equal to 0. Example, helium 2 4, carbon 6 12, oxygen 8 16. Number of protons are odd, number of neutrons are even. Half integral spin, 1 by 2. Out of this, 2 1 should be odd. Okay. Or number of protons are even, number of neutrons are odd. Half integral spin. For example, carbon 6 13, already we have discussed this. Okay, out of these two, one should be odd, either number of protons or number of neutrons, and one should be even. It is having the half integral spin. Okay, now last odd even, it is given here, 3 by 2. So these are the few examples here, number of protons, number of neutrons and spin number. So nuclear spin is very, very important here. Let us going to discuss now the theory of nuclear magnetic resonance. This diagram shows spinning nucleus, and that spinning nucleus is having the nuclear spin. Okay, the charge of nucleus, regarded as a spinning sphere, generates a magnetic field. When it is spinning around its own axis, this diagram you can see, it generates a magnetic field. It means that it is itself a tiny magnet. This spinning nuclei, it is a tiny magnet. It produces the magnetic field. Okay. The nucleus is therefore associated with a nuclear magnetic moment, mu. The nucleus is therefore associated with a nuclear magnetic moment mu along the axis of the spin. See here, along the axis of the spin. Thus, the spinning nucleus acts as a magnet, tiny magnet. Okay, the axis of the, it is having the axis of the spin. It is, it acts as a magnet, tiny magnet or bar magnet. The nuclear magnetic moment for the proton is called nuclear magneton. The nuclear magnetic moment for that proton, because that proton, it is spinning, so it is having the magnetic moment. Okay, so the nuclear magnetic moment for proton is called nuclear magneton. It is expressed in Tesla. This is the unit, Tesla, T. Okay. So mu, it is equal to Eh upon 4 pi mp, where E is the charge, H is the Planck's constant. Because proton is a charged particle, so its charge, it is given by this. Mp, mass of the proton, it is equal to 1.673 into 10 raised to minus. So mu equal to this. Okay, joule per, this is joule per Tesla. Okay. So thus, the proton, it is a spinning proton having the magnetic moment. Now, that spinning proton, it is having the spin angular momentum. Now it is spinning, so it is having the spin angular momentum. Okay, that spinning proton, it is having the spin angular momentum. The spin characteristics of nuclei are defined by a spin quantum number I. Okay, that is having the spin quantum number I, which gives rise to a spin angular momentum. The magnitude of the spin angular momentum is related to the spin quantum number I. It means that if the proton is having the nuclear spin, so it is having the spin quantum number I. So spin angular momentum, it is equal to, it is determined according to this equation, I into square root of under root of I into I plus 1. Spin angular momentum under root of I into I plus 1 h upon twice pi. Okay. When spin active nuclei, I it is not equal to 0. If you put here I equal to 0, then spin angular momentum should be equal to 0. That spinning proton is having the spin angular momentum. Just like the spinning electron is having the spin angular momentum. And it is given by this equation. Okay, it is given by this equation. Suppose that this is the equation one here. The spin active nuclei at is not equal to 0 are placed in a magnetic field of strength H0. Magnetic field is required here. Without magnetic field, we cannot get the NMR spectra. That spinning nuclei take up various discrete orientations depending upon the spin quantum number I, depending upon the nuclear spin I. Okay, for a given value of I, the possible orientations are, the possible orientations are twice I plus 1. Try to understand about this. When the spin active nuclei are placed into the magnetic field, we should have to place it into the magnetic field. The nuclei, it is splitted in various discrete orientation, number of the states. It is splitted into the number of the states depending on the spin quantum number I. For a given value of the I, the possible orientations are equal to twice I plus 1 in the magnetic field. Without magnetic field, there is no orientation. Magnetic field is very necessary. Without magnetic field, we are not getting the NMR spectra. Remember this. In the magnetic field, we are getting the NMR spectra. Suppose, for example, a nucleus containing only a proton with I equal to 1 by 2. For example, hydrogen, 1, 1, it is having I equal to 1 by 2. We'll be able to assume any one of the two possible orientation. Put here I equal to 1 by 2 in this equation, twice I, 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1. How many orientation it is having? Two orientations. Namely, plus 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. And that corresponds to the energy level plus mu into H0, where mu, it is the magnetic moment, and H0 is the H0, it is the magnetic field. Plus mu H0 and minus mu into H0 in the applied magnetic field. If the nuclei is having I, it is equal to 3 by 2 nuclear spin, then put here I equal to 3 by 2, 4 orientations are there, 4 energy levels. That 4 energy levels are 3 by 2, 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 3 by 2, 4 values. It is having 4 values. Thus, the value of the I determines the number of the orientations, and mu determines the energy level. Let us see the diagram for this. Consider a proton or the hydrogen nucleus. It has I equal to 1/2. Okay, hydrogen nucleus, it is having I equal to 1/2 here. Okay, when a proton is placed in a magnetic field, when that proton, try to understand this, when a proton is placed in the magnetic field, without magnetic field we cannot study the NMR spectra, and the magnetic field of the strength H0, it is H0, the number of orientations are equal to, two orientations are there. See here, this is in absence of the magnetic field. In absence, okay, in absence of the magnetic field, and this is in presence of the magnetic field. Okay, just like in the crystal field splitting, if you remember, in presence of the surrounding ligand field, the 5d orbitals are splitted into the two energy groups. That is known to us, T2g orbital and Eg orbital, in presence of the surrounding ligand field. And if there is no ligand field, 5d orbitals are degenerate. So in this case also, the possible orientations are takes place when magnetic field is applied. So if the proton is having I equal to 1/2, and if that proton is placed into the magnetic field of the strength H0, the number of the possible orientations are equal to 2. And the two orientation can be considered to be lower energy, that is parallel orientation aligned with the magnetic field, and high energy anti-parallel orientation aligned against the field. See here, this diagram. You can see that the nuclear spin will be splitted into the two energy state, lower energy state and higher energy state. Lower energy state, it is having the energy minus mu into H0. And higher energy state, it is having the energy plus mu into H0. Where H0, it is the magnetic field supply. Okay. Magnetic field supply there. And this difference delta E, it is equal to twice mu into H0. This minus this, plus mu H0, minus in bracket minus mu H0. You can see here, delta E. How can you calculate the delta E here? Delta E, it is equal to this plus mu H0, higher energy state minus in bracket minus mu H0. Okay. What is here? Minus 1/2 plus 1/2. The spin will be splitted into the two orientation, minus 1/2 and plus 1/2. Okay. So this is equal to twice mu H0. Okay. Then if I equal to 3/2, the number of the orientations are 4. Minus 3/2, minus 1/2, plus 1/2, plus 3/2. So nuclear spin is very, very important here. And in presence of the magnetic field, we can see the energy levels here. See here. Energy levels in magnetic field. Energy levels in a magnetic field. Okay. So try to understand about this. See here. Since the parallel orientation has a lower energy, parallel means it is parallel to the magnetic field. It is more stable, whereas anti-parallel orientation, which has a higher energy level, it is less stable. See here, this is in absence of the magnetic field, already explained by me. Now, the proton which is having I equal to 1/2, splitted into the two energy state, minus mu H0 and plus mu H0 in presence of the applied magnetic field. This is with the magnetic field, parallel orientation. This is against the magnetic field, anti-parallel orientation. So this figure represents parallel and anti-parallel orientation of a proton in a magnetic field. Parallel and एंटी पैरेलल ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ अ प्रोटॉन इन अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. इन दिस वे द प्रोटॉन इट इज स्प्लिटेड इनटू द टू एनर्जी स्टेट, लोअर एनर्जी स्टेट एंड हायर एनर्जी स्टेट, एंड इट इज हैविंग द टू ओरिएंटेशंस. ओके, पैरेलल ओरिएंटेशन एंड एंटी पैरेलल ओरिएंटेशन.